40 years ago. My father did not teach me his language. I barely knew him as my father.
I'm Jay Live, Justice of Law, straight out of New York City. CEO, founder of Triple Threat Productions, new artist on BBE. I'm coming out May 27th called Then What Happened.
Oh man, because my mother gave me food for thought and belly.
Does this have any?
Well, I've been rapping since I was about 12 years old. You know, it kind of evolved from the hallway to the basketball courts to the cafeterias to the talent shows. My first single came out when I was 19. It was Bragamites and Longevity, sort of a cult classic as far as 12 inches go. First album came out, it was supposed to come out in 99, it came out 2001, it's called The Best Part. Followed it up in 2002 with All of the Above. 2003 with Always Has Been, Always Will Be. 2005 with The Hereafter. And then just recently we put out an EP called Reveal the Secret, which is a prelude to the album we're dealing with now called Then What Happened.
Yeah,
I've been working on the album for about a year and a half. I get all of my titles out of 120 Lessons as a 5%er. Then What Happened is one very short degree in a conversation between Elijah Muhammad and W.D. Fard. And I sort of take that conversation and adapt it to my own life in the intro of the record. Generally speaking, in terms of the whole record, it's just more of a sort of journal of where I'm at with my life right now. Fully grown up, you know, from student to teacher, from son to father, from new artist to elder. So it's just sort of a progression in that sense, and each song kind of leads to the next one. So that's why it was a fitting title for the record, Then What Happened.
Mentally blind, with too much on his mind at one time, the short fuse, fiending for the clash of the type.
Well, I pretty much, you know, shied away from the traditional big budget, can't afford a studio, and, you know, just used sort of experience and technical know-how to record the whole thing in-house. And in my house, the best, most suitable room acoustically was my kid's bedroom. And the best spot in the kid's bedroom was just along the bunk bed, between the bunk bed and the wall, so you just sort of set it up with a quick makeshift treatment. And I mean, if you listen to the record, I dare compare it with the job that Probe DMS did out of Harlem. I compare it to pretty much anything that's out right now as far as sound quality. But it just goes to show you, you know, necessity being the mother of invention, you can pretty much get stuff done how you need to in your house.
Like dying do, that's what I'm going through. So Jay can get live at a venue near you. That's why I quit the job way back in 02.
Just sort of spit about whatever's on my mind, and my mind wanders a lot. So try to touch on topics I haven't touched on before. Sometimes old soul records will give me inspiration. The kind of records that I look to for guidance and advice, you know, like just Stevie Wonder's, the Bob Marley's of the world. Just current events, looking outside my window, see how things are going down. My lessons, my culture, my family, just every day. Definitely as a DJ, I definitely draw a lot of inspiration from new hip-hop and old hip-hop, you know, where it's been and where it's going. So, yeah, pretty much, I just let all of those things sort of guide my pen.
Into a smash, javelin, spears, long jump, high jump, so many hurdles in here. Take a pole, I've bought into the vault with the greats.
No, I've done, we're here in Cargo now. I've done Cargo a couple of times. I've done the Jazz Cafe a few times. I've done the Brixton Max, I've done the Scala. Couple places I can't remember to mention. They show me a lot of love out here, and that's why we keep coming back. You know?